I went to Muji. Last weekend I went to London with a friend of mine. We went for 4 days. And obviously I wanted to go to Muji. There are like three Muji stores in London. There's one on Oxford Street where we went. There's one in Covent Garden where we also went to. And there's one on Carnaby Street, I think, which is pretty close to the Oxford Street one. So don't really have to go there, but yeah, there are quite some Muji stores there, and I really wanted to go there because Muji is one of my favorite stores to buy stationery like pens and notebooks. So I obviously went all out, so I'm gonna show you what I got, and I'll also try to insert maybe some pictures of London because London is cool and nice, and if you can go there, then definitely go there. But yeah, let's get started, I guess. First of all, I got some washi tape, and those are actually not for me because I own these washi tape sets already, and they're really nice, they're really great to use and really nice to work with. These are the only sets that they have, so they have one that's like a plain washi tape in like three different colors, and they have two sets that have like the similar prints but in different colors. I got these for my mom because she wanted to have them as well, so I decided to get them for her so she can try them as well. I won't unpack them here, but there's quite a lot of tape on it, so yeah, you know, they're a little more expensive, of course, than like washi tape from AliExpress or maybe Action, if you know that store. Yeah, but I think they're personally definitely worth it. I use them a lot. I really like this one, especially like this one I used for June, actually, if you have seen my June plan with me. And this one's also really nice. So I think, yeah, it really fits the brand. Like Muji is quite simple and plain, so I think these washi tapes definitely fit the brand, and they're really nice to use. So yeah, they're definitely worth getting if you go to Muji. Then I got one regular notebook. It's a dotted one. I already own this in an A5 size, and I use it as like my creative journal, where I paint in and make like little like collages, I guess, like scrapbooking style things. And I saw that they also have an A6 one, so I kind of wanted to try this one as well. And I think, similar to the A5 one, I won't be using this as like an actual bullet journal, but more like a journal to do creative stuff in, or maybe write stories in or something like that. And I really like the look of it because it has like the brown cover, the binding on the side, which works really well because you can then like flip it over like this. So that's quite convenient if, for example, you're really messy and your desk is always a mess and you need something that's small. But yeah, I mean, I'm gonna try this out. Generally, the paper quality of Muji is actually quite good. It's not the thickest paper, but it does remind me a little bit of the Leuchtturm paper, which has like this smooth coating on it. And then it's a little thicker than the Leuchtturm paper, so the ghosting is a little less. So in general, yeah, the paper quality is just fine. Like, it's not the best, but it's definitely not the worst either. Then some random things. I got these sticky notes, which are actually like an empty calendar that you can fill in. And I thought that would be handy because then I don't have to draw out the calendar when I want to do a calendar in my journal. So yeah, I got this one as well. It doesn't have that many sheets. It only has 13. So you can do like a year and 1 month with it. But, you know, it's fine. I don't think it was that expensive either. And then I got this nail care set, which is like super random, but I forgot to take one with me when I went on the trip. And then of course my nails started to rip apart. So I got this set, and I actually kind of like it because it's really small. So I'll probably put this in like my travel bag so that I can grab it next time I'm going on a little trip. Still, yeah, again, it fits the Muji style of like super plain and simple, which I absolutely love. So that's great. Then I got some more notebooks, and I actually got these passport size notebooks, and I got them for a reason, because currently I'm using like a regular journal, but I would really like to switch to the traveler's notebook style journals, but not necessarily the traveler notebook brand, because it's kind of hard to get in the Netherlands, so if I would run out of paper, that would be really annoying. So what I did is I bought an actual passport cover on AliExpress. So this is a leather one and a dark blue color. And a colleague of mine came over from London to the Netherlands, and she bought one of these books for me, and actually the sizing was pretty good for like this type of cover. So what I wanted to do is get some more of these notebooks, also in different like paper styles, because I only had the dotted one, but they have three styles. And then the idea is to have like a traveler notebook kind of style like this. Currently I have like these hair ties on it to keep them in place, but I will probably punch some holes in this cover and then do a proper elastic band so it doesn't look all bendy here. But yeah, that's the plan, and that will probably be my next journal when my A6 Leuchtturm is all filled up. But obviously I wanted to get some more books to put in there, so the blue one is actually the dotted one. It doesn't have that many pages, by the way, so if you are getting this one, it has like 24 pages, so it's quite thin. But I think I could fit like 1 month in here. So what I was thinking, I used the blue one for actual like planning. Then the red one is actually completely blank, so it has blank paper. So I was thinking this is a nice one to do like doodling and sketching, which I often do for stickers. So I can do like some, make some IDs in here, and then if I really like it, I can actually draw it on my iPad. And then the green one has grid paper, so it's like the square grid paper. I've seen people use this as a bullet journal as well instead of the dots, and I do like the style of it, so maybe I'll actually use this one instead of the other one. Or what I was also thinking is use the blue one with the dots for the actual planning part, and then if I want to do like journaling, reflecting, like more of a diary style, I might actually use this one. So yeah, we'll just play around with that. I do really like the size of these books. I do like the paper, it's a little more yellow than the older book, but the difference is not that big. So yeah, I'm gonna give that a try, and this was a good purchase to use for that. And then lastly, but certainly not least, I got a pencil case, like a pen case, and of course I got a bunch of pens there as well. The pen case was empty, by the way, so you don't buy it like this. But yeah, I like the pen case actually. It's let's get this out of it first. It's like not completely transparent, but a little bit, so you can kind of see where your pen is sitting in the case. I do like the size. I currently have a really happy Mickey Mouse one, actually, and I will probably switch to this one because it's a little bit bigger, so that's good. Like, it's a little broader, so it can fit bigger pens. And looks a little more mature, maybe. And it has a little pocket in here, actually. Like, this thing that you see here is actually a pocket. So you could, for example, put your eraser in there, or something small that you always lose. So I think that would be handy as well. And then I got a bunch of pens. I really, really, really like the Muji pens. And especially their black gel pens. They have different styles now of gel pens. So I got these ones, which are like the ones that click, and they have this rubbery part here, which makes them a little more comfortable than the super basic ones that they have. So I already tried one out. I'm using one now for my bullet journal, and it's actually really great. I prefer it, I think, over the like the more basic style gel pen from Muji, because this has a better grip, and when you write with it, it's similar. So I think the good part about the Muji gel pens is that they don't skip when you write with them. So sometimes gel pens have the tendency to skip over, so that really annoys me if they do, but these don't, so that's great. And they also dry up fairly quickly, so that works well. So I got like 4 of those, so I want to write with, and some backups. Maybe I'll give them to my mom as well, but I don't know if she wants them. Then Muji now has a brush pen, and obviously I wanted to try it out. It's hard to use. I tried it already, but it's pretty hard to use. Because the tip is quite long, like not too long, but quite long, and really soft. So it's softer than, for example, the Tombow ones. So yeah, I'll have to play around with this and see if I can make it work. But yeah, I just wanted to give it a try, so I still got it. Then I got some of the basic style gel pens. They have these in various thicknesses, so they have 0.38, they have 0.5 and 0.7. I got 6 of the 0.5 ones because that's my favorite width or like thickness. So I just bought some backups so I have enough to work with. And there's now a 07, which I never really noticed before, so I don't know if it's new or not. But I wanted to give that a try as well, because sometimes this can still be quite thin, so maybe this will work better for me. Yeah, just gonna give them a try. And I think if there's anything that you should try from Muji, it's definitely these gel pens, because they work really well and they write really well. Then I got this correction pen, which is, yeah, you probably know this one if you ever used it for like school or anything. It has like the liquid correction stuff in here, and then you have to push it to get it out. I recently got this from Hema, and then it just didn't really work, and I got super frustrated with it. And then I thought maybe I should give the Muji one a try, and I already tried it, and it works actually really well. Like, it flows really easily, and it dries fairly quickly, so yeah, this will be really handy. And then lastly, I got this thing. This is a fountain pen, which I never really realized that they have as well. Like 2 months back, I got the Lamy fountain pen, which is absolutely awesome, but it's quite bulky. I have like the Safari ones, and it's like the cheapest one that they have, and it's still over 20 euros. So I wanted to give this one a try. I think it's really pretty actually, and I love how it's super slim, so I think this will fit better with my journal than the Lamy one, so it's a little easier to carry. It came with a cartridge as well, a black one actually, which I love, so I will look out for some more of those cartridges. But yeah, I really like the look of it. It has like this alloy metal feel. Not too sure how you call it in English, but it's just really simple, and it really definitely fits the Muji design. So yeah, I'm happy that I got this. It was a little more expensive than the other pens. Not too sure how expensive, maybe like £8 or something, so that would be like 9 euros. But still definitely cheaper than the Lamy one, so happy to try this one. And then that's basically all I got at Muji. Yeah, actually really enjoyed going there again. I should have definitely filmed in that store, and I definitely didn't, so that was kind of stupid. But yeah, if you ever get a chance to go to Muji, definitely check it out. And I hope that you enjoyed this haul. So I'll see you next time. Bye bye.